Hey everyone, your motherboard will have an option to disable Compatibility Support Module, CSM, which allows your computer to work with older BIOS and boot disks, and also newer UEFI-based systems. But some users have found that after disabling CSM, the PC doesn't boot up at all anymore, or it goes straight to Windows and doesn't allow you into the BIOS. Or maybe it boots up fine, but the monitor starts giving you weird messages about the resolution being wrong. If any of this is happening to you, fear not, because here's six possible fixes for this problem. Firstly, if you can still get into the BIOS and you have a legitimate need to disable CSM, you should try enabling secure boot. Unfortunately, the exact way of doing this varies a lot, depending on your motherboard make. But on ASUS, you should be able to go to boot and then choose Windows UEFI mode under the OS type. On an MSI motherboard, you should go to Settings, Advanced, Windows OS Configuration, and then enable Windows 10 WHQL support. Hopefully at this point you can now restart, get output on your monitor, and boot up into Windows. If you don't get output though, don't worry, because I'll cover this exact issue in just 1 minute. But if you do get output but Windows isn't booting up properly, it's likely the Windows was originally installed in legacy mode when CSM was enabled. To be technical, the disk partition where Windows was installed was set up as MBR instead of the newer GPT. You can check this under Disk Management when you're booted up into Windows, although naturally you might need to actually remove your disk and put it into a working Windows install to actually check this. Right-click on the volume, click Properties, then Hardware, and then Properties again, then Volumes, and finally Populate. View. If the partition style says Master Boot Record, your Windows was installed in legacy mode, which is kind of why CSM is actually needed to be enabled in the first place. There's some great guides out there that show you how to convert a disk from MBR to GPT, so I'll pop links to those down in the description. Okay, so those 2 points cover when you can actually boot up and see things on the screen. If you don't see any output at all, don't worry, this is surprisingly common after disabling CSM, especially if you have multiple monitors. After starting your PC, wait a minute, and then try holding down the Windows key and pressing P. This will allow you to change which monitor should show output. Sometimes pressing P a few times, and maybe the up and down arrows too, can nudge the output back onto your main monitor. But if not, if you connect your PC to your monitor with a DisplayPort cable, change this to a HDMI cable instead. Sometimes switching to HDMI and then restarting will allow you to boot up and see output on your monitor again. You can then either use this window of opportunity to fix your BIOS settings and then switch back to a DisplayPort cable, or just live with a HDMI cable for the rest of your life. Either works. If you still don't have any luck, then the next thing you can try is, if you have integrated graphics on your CPU, you can remove the HDMI cable from your graphics card and plug it directly into your motherboard. Then restart. This can sometimes help to resolve these output oddities. However, if nothing else has worked so far, power off your PC, take the power cord out and open the case up. Locate the CMOS battery, which is a flat, round, pocket cell battery. Its location will vary depending on your exact motherboard. Mine is thankfully fairly easy to get to, so I can just use a small flathead screwdriver to pry it out of its slot. But some people might actually need to remove components to get to the CMOS battery. After removing it, wait a few minutes, which can help to clear out any weird motherboard settings that are contributing to your boot up problems. Then put the battery back, and then after booting back up, you should be taken back into the BIOS, where you can reconfigure everything and hopefully fix this issue once and for all. Remember to enable secure boot or a similar setting if you have to disable CSM. And that wraps up this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. This tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.